crazy for you.
I paid them all to do that. So that was, I got you, Venmo. Okay.
What is your name?
My name is Jordan Connolly.
How old are you?
I'm 29.
And where do you come from?
I'm from Garden Grove, California.
And you came here to dance?
No, I actually came here to do stand-up comedy. Oh.
Jordan, how long have you been a comedian?
I've been doing it for 7 years now.
Okay, yeah. And that's how you make a living?
I would like to say yes, but also, do you want your fries with more ketchup? You know what I mean? Like, does
yeah,
that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, I just want to confirm. That's, so yeah.
But that didn't discourage you because here you are.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
So what is your dream? Where do you see yourself in the future?
I have very, very big dreams. So my dream right now is all based off of Kevin Hart. Kevin Hart did a football stadium. I think it was like 73,000 people. My goal is 73,001.
That's ambition.
Okay, so let's see what you've got.
Okay, thank you. So, I come from a very tough upbringing. Like, I have a military family. My parents met in the Marine Corps. Like, that's where my parents met, right? Like, my dad came to me, he was like, yo, it'd be so cool if my oldest son could join the military. I was like, Dad, it'll be so cool if you adopted somebody older than me. You know? I'm not that guy. I feel like if you're gonna go overseas, you need to be willing to take secrets to the grave. I'm not that guy, okay? You know what I mean? Like, if I go overseas, let's say I get captured, I become a prisoner of war. I'm telling my secrets, your secrets, and Victoria's secrets. You know what I'm saying? I'm telling them all. Like, I could be in a hostage situation and this guy's trying to threaten me. He's like, what's it gonna take to get the secrets from you? I'm like, sir, a pen and paper, just. Listen, give me that. Put the knives away. This is a celebration. You caught the right guy, okay? The toughest person in my family is by far my mom. She's tough. She's old school. Like, if you ever got in trouble with her, she would turn whatever situation with you into a horror movie scene, I promise you. There's one day, she says, Jordan, didn't I tell you to come downstairs to do these dishes? You better do these dishes before you get in trouble. I lost in a video game. I got angry. I snapped. I said, you ain't done nothing all day. I suggest you stay downstairs and do them dishes before you get in trouble. Out of nowhere, this is all I heard.
Who the hell you think you're talking to?
As soon as I heard that voice, all the power in my house cut off, okay? The lights cut off, these crows came out of my closet, my windows opened up, there was these two little girls in a school uniform jumping rope and singing. They were like, one, two, your mama's coming for you. I woke up a week later confused. Thank you guys.
There's something about your energy. I think you have all the future ahead of you.
Thank you so much.
You are just naturally funny because you are super, super talented.
Absolutely.
When you did The Voice, you really cracked me up.
This was a really, really, really good audition. I like you a lot.
You are so fast. It's crazy how you go from here to there and here to there, but like I was like following. And then we're in your house and I was there with you and it was all funny. And I'm doing the same thing to my kids when they don't behave. Guess what?
You know, there are certain people. You mentioned Kevin Hart. And one of the things that makes these people stars is there are people that come out and then they do an act. And then there are people that come out, you believe there's no separation between who that person is and this is not an act. The difference is people go, I love Kevin Hart. People are gonna say, I love Jordan Connolly. It's not his act, I love him.
So we're gonna vote. I'm gonna give you your first yes.
give you roughly 4,000 yeses.
I've never seen you laugh so much.
It was so funny.
Like, you were really like, you were doing like this thing.
Oh, Jordan, hey, man, give me a hug, give me a hug. Oh. You look emotional.
How many, a bee fell in my eye during the performance.
Oh, little life.
Is that you, Deck? Please, sir, tell us your name.
I'm Ned.
How old are you, Ned?
I'm 8.
And where are you from?
Maidstone.
Oh. Who's here with you today?
Well, I'm with my mum, my dad, my stepmum, my sister, my other sister, and my brother.
Fantastic. Do you perform for friends and family? Do you get up in school and do shows?
Yeah.
The stage is yours, sir. Good luck.
Come on, Ned.
Why were people so excited about that talking dog on Britain's Got Talent? Amanda Holden's been on it for years. And Deck backstage, but I'm never quite sure which one's supposed to be the funny one.
Oh, he's killing us all!
Alicia?
Oh no.
Yeah. Alicia laughing?
Oh no.
Alicia not dancing?
That was good.
Simon.
What's up?
He reminds me a lot of my dad. He's a cross-dresser. He gets especially cross when he can't find his socks. I was really worried for David Williams when he swam on the River Thames for charity because of all that garbage going in his mouth. But since I've been watching BGT, I'm relieved it's all coming out again.
Well done, Ned. I loved the way that you took the Mickey out of us. It was really quite savage. No.
Oh, hello, Tony. Can't go.
Woo. Tony's gonna take it off.
I'm wearing a pants.
Yes.
But I can pose naked.
Oh, okay? No, don't.
No, thank you.
Number one, football player naked pose. Come on. Don't worry, I'm wearing
pants.
Okay. Number two. Okay, horse racer naked pose. Come on. Number three, James Bond, naked pose.
James Bond, yeah.
Come on.
Come on.
much.
Don't worry, I'm wearing.
Pass!
Hey!
It's genius.
Finally!
Don't stop!
Spice Girls!
Spice Girls!
Wannabe!
Wannabe!
Naked pose! Come on!
Come on! Tony, you might actually be my favorite contestant of the whole series so far.
Thank you. Arigato.
No, arigato gozaimasu to you.
Yeah, thank you. Oh my God.
Come on, Tony. Bruno, what did you
think? Listen, I have to say, you definitely have balls. Great. What can
thank
I say?
Thank you.
Nanda,
Tony, you are absolutely unique. And it felt very Britain's Got Talent. I loved it.
Thank you.
Simon?
Honestly, you are the funniest contestant we've had on all year. Seriously.
Funny boy!
Really, really funny and original.
Thank you. Simon Naked Paul?
No.
Simon?
No. Always keep them waiting, Tony.
We are going to have to take a vote now, though.
Oh, it's a yes from me.
Yes.
Amanda?
It's a yes from me, Tony.
Thank you.
Tony Kaku.
Tony Kaku.
It's a yes from me.
Really?
Yes. Simon?
Tony, honestly, you are unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
You are brilliant.
Simon, love me.
I absolutely love you.
Unbelievable.
You have four yeses.
Yes! Yes! Thank you, guys!
Thank you, baby!
Axel Blake, and I'm from West London.
So, Axel, what made you sign up for BGT this year?
Well, I've got a 12-year-old son. He's in the audience.
Nice!
Yeah. So I just wanted him to believe in yourself, you know? Put your mind to it and you can make it happen.
And do you have a day job?
Yes, I do property maintenance. If you need a kitchen done, Simon, let me know.
I do, actually, Axel.
Give me a call.
I will.
Good.
I want a good rate.
No.
Come, we're friends now.
Yeah, OK, cool. Press that and we're cool, yeah?
I'm really curious with you, because you've got your day job, this is obviously what you want to do. Has there ever been a moment where you've almost lost your confidence and thought, I'm not going to do this?
100%, it's been that time. But when you have family that's looking at you and inspired by you, that's what keeps you going.
Yeah.
So my son and my daughter, that's the reason. That's the reason.
All right, well, we wish you the best of luck. Go for it.
How are we doing, ladies and gentlemen? Make some noise! I was going to drive here today. I realised I don't have a licence, so... Don't worry, I drove anyways. I took the tube. I've got a love-hate relationship with the tube, you know? I love when it's empty, I hate when it's packed. Can't stand it. Fight people off for the armrest. You ever done that? Think... No, you don't. This old lady is strong. Oh, my... Have it, Margaret, have it. Just have it. Some people do their makeup on the tube as well. Make some noise if you've ever done your makeup on the tube. Legend. A couple weeks ago, I saw a woman, she was doing her whole makeup. A few stops later, she was a whole new person. I was so impressed, I started clapping. I was like, you know what? Yeah, you know. She looked down on me like, I thought, you may be a 9 out of 10 now, but you was a minus 2 at King's Cross, love. Yeah. Boom. Yeah. I walked off the train like this, in style, yeah. But on a brighter note, just recently my fiance gave birth to a little baby girl. Don't clap, Simon, don't clap. I didn't say the baby's mine, did I? I'm joking, she's mine. Pandemic baby as well, you know? Aww. Yeah, so we wanted to give her a fitting name, so we named her Pfizer, yeah? Yeah. I call her Faisha, yeah? Faisha.
Oh, he's very good!
Technology is moving at such a crazy speed. Evolving crazy. You got the metaverse, you know, you got cryptocurrency. I still get excited about my contactless card when I use it. I do, when I use it, beep. I love the noise. I've got a jacket with a pocket on his arm. Sometimes I'll leave my card in the arm and I'll pay with my arm. Just to confuse the cashier. That'll be £19.30. Boop. Next week I'm going back, I'm gonna leave my card in my back pocket. I'll be £22.60. Boop. Yeah. Yeah. Then I walk off.
Whoa! He gets a standing ovation and hasn't said a word.
I love him.
Thank you very much, everybody.
For the odd person that is watching at home or doesn't know, you are a superstar from this last season, season 17,
yes,
on AGT. You blew up. You're a comic superstar. I know you've been traveling. I know I offered you a job with me opening up. You haven't had time.
Haven't had time.
That's how busy. People are recognizing you on the street. With all that going on, why come back for more?
Here's the thing. I didn't win. That's why I was here.
There you go.
I wanted the title. I wanted to be the first comedian ever. And then when I left, I was devastated.
Good for you.
So when I got the call, I never stopped working. And I just kept tightening, writing, fixing everything. Yeah. You know? You want a show?
Yes, we do. Yeah.
No more questions. Give us the show.
Okay.
I love him for saying that.
Yeah. He came to win.
Thank you, all right. Okay. So, AGT has been changing my life, but it's been changing my family's life even more, especially my stepson. For those of you that don't know, my wife's older, I got a stepson, we like the same age, I call him Stepman, all right? And he's been exhibiting unusual behavior because he's upset that I portrayed him on the show as irresponsible and gets in trouble in school. So he's been trying to prove he's responsible by buying products around the house with my money. And I didn't even know. I walked in on him eating his cereal. I'm like, hey, don't waste that milk. He's like, I bought it. And he doesn't waste the milk. He walks the bowl of milk past the sink and places the bowl of milk inside of the refrigerator. So first I'm like, who reuses cereal milk? But then I was like, how good would my cereal taste double cocoa puffed up? All these years I've been single milking it. I just needed my milk to marinate. The fame is affecting Stepman. He's been invited to all these parties, but he's been staying out too late. So my wife and I, we've been deciding how to handle it. I'm like, I don't know what to do. She's like, go get him. I drove around the corner to pick him up. I came home 3 hours later. She said, Michael, you've been drinking? I'm like, we got some of the same friends. Everybody was there. He's still there. I'ma go get him again. I'll find out why you weren't invited. And on top of all of that, I have responsibilities in the community. I'm a Little League coach, yes. Yeah. Yeah, we have a 12-year-old together. Yeah, that's the one we call Real Kid. And they call me Coach Fro because I can't fit the hat. I just set it on top. I love coaching, you know? I just hate when kids get hit by the pitch because it is not supposed to be funny. But baseball is a game of technique. When the ball's coming at you, you turn and you brace. But a lot of the kids, they get afraid and they get hit in the worst places, like the center of the back, and I see it happening. The ball's coming and they turn and they're like, ah! And the worst thing you can do when you're holding in your laugh is look at another person. You know? And the kid's like, I can hear you. The pitch was 25 miles per hour. She's trying to kill me. Hey, you guys, I'm Mikey Winfield. Thank you very much, America. Thank you, America.
Danny O for Mikey.
Thank you very much. Thank you all.
Heidi.
Hi. Love you. There is that superstar smile. That superstar smile, and you are that ray of sunshine, and I love you, you're hilarious, and I will be double milking from now on.
Thank you, Heidi.
I will do it tomorrow morning.
Mike, you know what? I think if you had done that routine in the final, it might have been a completely different story, because you've come back funnier, more confident. I can even see it in your eyes how much this means to you right now.
It means everything. Thank
that.
You.
I can see that.
This is what I've been wanting forever. I wanted AGT. I've been doing this for like 20 years. And you go unnoticed, and you finally get a platform. There's no time to take off or put on breaks. I'm here to play.
You know what, Mike? Love, love, love people who compete, and I wasn't expecting to do this, but I'm gonna do it.
Thank you, Simon.
I really like you.
Yeah, thank you. Mike E. Winfield, you are going straight to the All-Star finale.
Dude, I see you getting emotional up there, man. This is All-Stars, and I am. I'm trying to hold it back.
Got me, Heidi.
He's funny and he's a fighter and he really wants it.
Hello, everyone. My name is He. It's spelled as H-E, and that's it. Yes, it is my name. It is not my pronoun. People get confused all the time. The other day I was drinking in a pub. This cute boy came up to me. He was like, yo, what's your name? I said, my name is He. He was like, huh? I said, He, H-E, sir. And he said, nice to meet you, Ho. I was like, what? Excuse me? I am not a Ho. You know, that's my cousin. Yeah, she is a Ho. You know? Her mom is a Ho. And her dad is a Ho too, you know? Those Hoes are loyal, though. Yeah. As you can tell from my outfit, that I was made in China. Yes. Look, guys, I'm really sorry for the COVID. Yeah? Yeah, I'm sorry for it, but I didn't do it. I was here the whole time. I know. Oh, thank you. Yeah. Yeah, last year I was roaming around in the city and this guy just yelled at me. He was like, yo, go back to China. I was like, sir, there's no flight. I left China about 3 years ago because I feel pathetic. Yes, people are really judgmental. If you're like me, over the age of 27, not dating or not married in China, you'll be called leftover ladies. I know it is brutal, but I love leftovers. Come on, who doesn't love Chinese leftovers?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, the best.
I know, thank you. We are yummy and cheap. That is my Tinder bio. Chinese leftover, yummy. Just take me home and eat me. I know. Yes. My parents are the one who always push me to get married. I remember my 30th birthday, my dad just told me. He was like, huh. Can you lower your standards and get a husband? I was like, what, Dad? I don't have any standards. You know, just like my mom. Yep, I know. Yeah, yeah. I don't understand why people want to get married. Almost all of my married friends are miserable. The other day, I was chatting with a friend. She was complaining that I wish I hadn't married, you know? All the BS from my in-laws. My husband is lazy. My kid is a failure. I was like, what the heck, Mom? Are you serious, you know? No wonder I'm not married. That's my time. Thank you guys so much. Thank you.
Music, start.
Balloon.
What's that?
The dart, I think. Oh, no!
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
There's no other place for you, really, than this show.
I can assure you one thing. It's not fake. It's real.
I am literally speechless. It's like an out-of-body experience.
Listen, one series on this show, that will become normal.
Oh, my God.
I can't believe that I enjoyed that. I actually really enjoyed it. What I'm most looking forward to is potentially saying, Your Royal Highness King Charles, may we proudly present the winner of Britain's Got Talent. We're going to take a vote, Ichikawa. It's a yes from me.
Thank you.
Alicia, I enjoyed that, but I don't know if I want to see it again. What? You want to see it again? OK, for the potential, it's a yes.
Thank you!
Bruno.
Oh, it's a no for me. but it's a no. I mean... Here we go!
Simon.
Well, I didn't know what was going on. I genuinely hadn't got a clue. And then I understood. I remember watching Rocky for the first time, thinking one of the most suspenseful, exciting end of a movie I've ever seen, and that was up there.
I've never wanted a balloon to burst so much in my life. Take that buzzer away. By the wind beneath my wings. I am thrilled to give you your third yes. Did
I ever tell you?
Everybody.
Nice to meet you, and what's your name?
My name is Mr. Pants.
Mr. Pants, I don't know how to say it, but your fly is open and something is poking out.
Is that your real name?
Yes.
What, Mr. Pants?
Mr. Pants, can we get a Q-tip for Simon over here? It's Mr. Pants.
Okay, Mr. Pants, tell me where you're from.
Brooklyn, New York.
What is your day job?
Well, I used to go to the office every day, but since the pandemic, I've been virtually replaced by sweatpants.
Okay. You're a comedian?
Sir, yes, sir. I'm here to dazzle you at my stand-up comedy routine.
So what's the dream, Mr. Pants?
Vegas, baby.
Okay, I'm not going to ask any more questions. Complete waste of time. Good luck.
Thank you. I'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Pants!
Please, Terry, my father was Mr. Pants. Look, I'm gonna make this brief. I only got one day left on my return policy. I inherited my father's genes. He immigrated here from a banana republic. It was very hard on me growing up. He used to call me a huge waste. You see, both of my parents wanted me to become a lawyer. Never even came close to becoming a lawyer, but I was once involved in a suit. But I've since traveled the world. Went to Spain, fell madly in love with a Spanish sundress. Then we broke up and I was pantalones.
I love him.
But I'm happily married now.
Aw.
My wife and I are poly. It's polyester. Our daughter Capri brought home a pair of sweatpants. Hey, I want to be a supportive father, but I want to see her date someone ironed with a crease. This guy looked like he'd been donated. She asked if he could spend the night. I said, in my house, you'll sleep in separate drawers. Hey, guys, I'd love to tell you more jokes, but unfortunately, I left him in my other pants. Thank you so much. You've been a lovely crowd of people.
Simon's face is like this.
Look at Simon's face.
In Norway, that means you're doing really good.
Oh.
Is there any more? Is there any more?
Come on, please.
Honestly?
We want
this to me.
Yes!
Right. Okay.
Any more?
You want more?
No. No.
I love this song so much. Good evening.
Hello.
What is your name?
My name is Aiko, and I am from Japan. I live here now, and daytime I'm a translator, and I love my job because when I screw up, I'm the only person who knows about it.
Yeah. So today you're coming to AGT to
yes.
do what?
I'm here to do a stand-up comedy.
You want to start already?
Sounds good to me.
Okay.
Okay. My name is Aiko. In Japanese, it means love child. So I look up the dictionary. It says illegitimate child. My last name is Tanaka. It means in the rice field. So my whole name is illegitimate child in the rice field. Oh. Nice to meet you. I love rice.
Me too.
Is this a rice crowd? Yeah. I just got the citizenship.
Yeah!
Until I got my citizenship, I never had a road rage. If somebody cut me off, I'd be like, oh, so sorry. I was driving too slow. But the day I got the citizenship, somebody cut me off. I'm like, what the heck? You can't cut me off. This is my land. That's when I realized I become true American.
Oh, that's great. He's hilarious.
Because I felt entitled. Before the citizenship, somebody hold the door for me. I ran really fast. I'm like, thank you so much. After the citizenship, I'm like, you hold the door, you peasant. I got sassy.
I love her.
Racist people always say immigrants should not be working. I agree. We work too much. Now, whenever I feel lazy and I take a nap, I'm like, I'm doing this for America. Thank you, that's my time.
I was really enjoying it, and I think all of us were enjoying
Everybody
it.
Everybody was.
Thank you. Good job.
Why are you so emotional?
I struggle with
insecurity, or a lot of people say I cannot do it because this is not my language. But then I had one person who really believed in me, which is my mom.
Your mom?
last year during pandemic, she passed away. Aww. She wanted me to go for my dream.
I love it.
How long have you been doing this?
For a few years. I perform everywhere. I perform in the prison. It's...
Well, it's important to have a captive audience, and
yes, you found one.
I think your career is about to skyrocket, young lady. Mama was right.
Heidi!
From jail to America's Got Talent. I also thought you were hilarious.
Thank you.
But since you have your citizenship, don't get into trouble.
No, get into trouble. That's going to be your bread and butter, I'm telling you.
But I had a lot of fun.
Simon, what did you think?
I mean, so funny, so naughty. From the minute you walked out, you got us. You know, and the best sign of a comedian's doing well, obviously, is the audience. And I really liked your reaction afterwards, because I could see how much this reaction meant to you as well. So I would like to give you your first yes.
Was she not brilliant, though?
Hilarious.
That was amazing.
Amazing.
Nice to meet you. Hello, everyone. Hi.
Hello.
Sorry. Bit nervous.
Who are you?
I'm Phil W. Green. I'm 21. And I'm going to be doing comedy impressions.
Hooray!
Philip, do you do this full time?
No, I don't, no.
What do you do?
I work at Body Shop at the moment as a customer consultant.
I bet your dream is to be a big international
yes,
star.
Yes, I'd love to be on stage.
Philip, did you bring anyone with you?
So, yeah, my friend Christy.
Does she work at Body Shop?
She did, but she's recently left.
Why?
Because she found a better job.
Found a better job!
Sorry!
Where?
She now works at Barrett's, so... Shoes!
I hope he's good after all of this.
OK, well, look, Philip, you've got roughly 2 minutes. Let's do it.
OK. Hello, I'm Natalie Cassidy. And today, we're going to be health working out. So everyone put your hands out in front of you, spread your legs, and do some squats. Lie down, the baby, on Martin Fowler's sofa. Isn't that right? Dawn Cotton would be proud, wouldn't she? Oh, it's so nice to be here on my wee show. And today's guest is absolutely fantastic. You know what? I'm going to meet her. Hello. Oh, thanks for having me, Charlotte. Oh, I'm so nervous. Oh, come on. And then, oh, I was on Guana Jungle recently. Oh, my God. I mean, I saw those ones, and I was like, whoa. And then I saw even more ones, and I was like, whoa. And then they tried to make me eat the ones, and I was like, whoa. And I was like, whoa. And I was being sick everywhere.
Oh, my goodness, have you seen the bacteria in here? It is awful. Isn't that right, Kim?
Oh, my love. Oh, that stinks. Darling, it's me, Louis Spence, dancing. Everyone like a duck. Come on, duck. Everyone, come on, duck. Everyone, duck, duck. And down, duck. And down, and Spence. Duck. Oh. Ooh. Oh.
Him.
right on the left.
The brilliant thing about your act was that you had us laughing before you even did anything.
Oh, thanks, Amanda.
David!
You're like a butch version of me. You're a very, very funny guy. I'd like to see some more of you in the act as well. Because you are hysterically funny as you as well.
Are you sure you're not related to Stacey Solomon?
I wish I was. I've seen her from a distance and I was in like, Stacey. But no.
I think you're really funny, lovable.
Do you need a wee?
No. I'm just really nervous. Sorry.
Simon?
It was like the world record for how many impersonations you can do in 2 minutes. I found it difficult to keep up with some of them. But the ones that were great.
Oh, thanks.
But you are a naturally funny guy.
Oh, thanks.
Slightly bonkers. But I like that.
You're gonna take a vote. David, yes or no?
I'm gonna say yes.
It's a yes from me.
Simon?
And we have actually had some good impressionists on the show this year. So you have got some competition. But I am going to say... yes.
Yay! That's four yeses. You're through for the next round.
Thank you so much. It's nice to meet you all. See you soon. Bye-bye.
Yeah!
Oh, my gosh.
Well done. You did it.
Funny guy.
He is very funny.
But it might be quite fun to have two impressionists in the final.
In an impression of.
So your first time out on stage doing this, how did it feel?
I'm so glad they laughed. That's all I can say. Like,
good. Yeah. Well, we'll see you again. You got four yeses. Well done.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
Celebrate.
See you next time. I can't believe it. I was so sorry. I was so good. Oh, my God. Oh. Hello.
Hello, darling.
Hello.
Hello, what's your name?
My name is Robert.
How old are you, Robert?
I just turned 30 11 years ago. So.
Is this your job, or do you have a normal job?
I teach tiny little primary school children music as well, so I do that, which is nice.
Okay, best of luck.
Right, so basically I've written a song specifically for you, which makes me nervous, and also I'm slightly nervous because I've got something called dyslexia, which was very good for music, because when I was young I taught myself the piano, although it's not so good as I'm older. I recently tried to book tickets for Rihanna, and I booked tickets for Ryanair. Thank you.
Oh, very good.
I've got something called Asperger syndrome, which means I'm a genius. No, it's nice to be here. I've had a bit of a rough week. I've actually moved into a flat with my boyfriend, yes, boyfriend, gay, and autistic, two ways I can't think straight. Thank you.
That is a good one.
So, I usually, when I do clubs, I swear a lot, so I've got to be PC. I've done a song which is literally PC, because it's about computers. And I have done it three times, and each time people have laughed, so if you don't, you're wrong. Here we go. Here we go. Thank you. George Formby, working in a computer shop. I work in the computer shop, make a computer bright and clean. So much crumbs and vomit, and don't ask what's on the screen. I do half the work, charge double the time, but you wouldn't want a job like mine if you would find the things I'd find when I'm cleaning Microsoft Windows. David Walliams wanted to update his content reminder. He brought me a massive ring binder. But when I looked, all the contacts were from Grindr. Cleaning rugs up windows. Alicia Dixon's webcam was another case. She said the picture was awful, but actually it was just her face.
Oh, no!
was too lovely, her face was too lovely. There you go. Amanda Holden was the only one whose Instagram was on the mark. She said her outfits have so much spark. I said, I'm just jealous I'll never dress like you because I don't shop in Primark.
I'm okay with that.
Cleaning Microsoft Windows. Simon Cowell's Facebook was around the bend. He brought it to me to try to mend. It wasn't broken. He's just got no friends. Cleaning Microsoft Windows.
Oh, Robert, I love you.
Wow.
I mean, everything you said was hilarious. You're just a beautiful soul. Comedy flows from you like water. I love that you had a go at us all. I think some people were more hurt than others. Some was just entirely truthful. But I just can't wait to see what you're going to do next.
Wow.
From start to finish, that was hilariously funny. You're a shining star. It's fantastic.
You're very self-deprecating, and I think that you have funny bones, and your audition was fabulous.
Thank you.
Really good.
Look, Robert, you know what? You're very unique, you're very quirky, very funny, very naughty. Robert. Which we like.
Thank you.
Thank you. David, yes or no?
It's a big fat yes!
Wow.
I'm saying yes.
I'm saying yes.
Robert White, you got 4 yeses. Congratulations.
Lovely man.
Where are you from?
I'm from South Norfolk.
What's your day job, Ben?
I do this act.
Okay, I'm not going to ask what it is because we like surprises.
Lush.
Tell me why you've entered the show this Lush. Year.
Well, my two little boys, they say, come on, Daddy, you've got to be on Britain's Got Talent.
So you've got sons, you've got kids.
I've got 2 children.
Okay, anything else?
Yeah, well, they did have a cat. Yeah.
Yeah. I won't go there. All right, Ben, good luck.
Thank you ever so much. Well, you see, I think my little stint now is all about me mishearing lyrics in music, see? I mean, it all started when I went to see The Lion King. Anybody see The Lion King? Yeah. Oh, I love The Lion King, but I must have misheard something, right? Because I thought the first song was about the Arsenal club football manager.
That's funny.
What I did then, right, I had a little think to myself. I thought, oh, maybe there's other songs, right, that you can hear that you think maybe they're singing something different, right? So I've amalgamated loads, and it's just for you. Hit it, Shirley! Come on, listening.
Yeah. There we go. There we go. Brilliant. Brilliant.
Thank you so much.
evening.
Good evening.
What's your name?
I'm Mickey.
Mickey?
Yeah.
Where are you from, darling?
I'm from the beautiful city of Leeds.
How old are you, Mickey?
I'm 36.
Do you have a day job or is this your full-time job?
I am a part-time primary school teacher.
Oh, lovely. Lovely.
Are you enjoying your food? Yeah, you've got to wait, you know.
The stage is yours, Mickey. Go for it.
Thank you very much. Cheers. This is called the absolutely amazing song.
Yes.
About travelling round Europe.
Oh.
That rhymes.
I like it.
I'm off to Paris in a Yaris. This next song. I know this is supposed to be a comedy routine, but I've suffered loss recently.
Oh, no.
So I just want to get this off my chest. Joe, I'll play the song because I get a bit emotional talking about it. I can't believe I've lost you. I can't believe you've gone. I need you to know that you did nothing wrong. First time I saw you, just hanging there. The checkout lady said, do you want to buy one of these? And I said, all right, go on then, yeah. You were my bag for life.
It's what?
My bag for life.
Forever. What?
My bag for life. You can either buy a teeth carrier bag or a bag for life, which is better quality and a bit more expensive.
Yes, I've paid the price.
You cost almost 10 pence and I only used you twice. The other bags I use compared to you are slack. I always feel that the handle strap is gonna... Has it happened to you a lot as well? Oh, back for life.
Hello?
Hello?
You look quite scary. Okay, so, sir, what is your name, please?
I'm Lioz.
Where are you from originally?
Israel.
What is it that you're doing today?
I'm a mentalist.
You're a mentalist?
I can read people's minds.
My power is mind reading, telepathy, and I can see the future. I don't do magic. I am the only one in the world with these abilities. The British audience are gonna see something that they never seen before. They're gonna be amazed.
Good luck.
Thank you.
I've seen this guy before in America.
Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening.
Why are you not doing?
Good evening.
Only you.
Is it you not doing
it? I did it.
You did it.
Huh? I said it.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you.
Sorry.
I need a volunteer. You. Come up on stage. What's your name?
Amanda.
Amanda?
Yes.
Tell the truth. Is that you?
Yes.
Here I have two boxes.
I want you to choose one of the boxes. Now, turn around, back to back. I want you to open the box. Inside, you will find plastic bags with different colors. Mm-hmm. I want you to think at one of the colors and take it out. Now, put the box on the floor. Open the plastic bag with two ends and think on the color. Now, I want you to count to 10 slowly, and both of us will turn to the audience at the same time. Mm-hmm. Start counting.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Well, wait, start from the beginning.
1, 2, 3.
Slowly.
1, 2.
Yeah, now it's good.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Thank you. It's souvenir.
Thank you.
But wait.
Oh.
No, I took something from you. You didn't even notice. Chegwood, what did I take from you?
What?
I took something from you. You're missing something. Here is your watch!
Thank you. Oh, it's good.
And you? I took something from you too. Good, what did I take from you? Here is your wallet! And you? No, your wallet! What's inside? Your wallet!
From laughing.
David, what did you think?
Well, I think you're an absolute comedy genius. It was brilliant.
It's not comedy.
Well, then I think you're screwed, because you're the world's worst mentalist.
It was genius. It was just brilliant. You had us in the palm of your hands. And you have an incredible presence about you. And it was hilariously funny.
Oh, it's mad.
I think the act is very, very funny, and I would love to see you go a long way.
I now understand that this guy is a genius. So I have to start this with a yes.
It's a yes for me.
It's a yes for me.
Four yeses. Thank you all. I love you, Britain. Thank you.
Amazing.
Yeah. Oh, I love it. Funny. Brilliant.
Hi.
Hi.
Who are you? Where are you from?
My name is Jack Williams.
Yes.
I am from Indianapolis, Indiana.
And I am guessing you are a magician.
Close. I am a ventriloquist.
Do you also know who is a very good ventriloquist?
Right there.
Exactly.
Fellow ventriloquist.
Yeah. We actually had 3 winners so far.
Exactly. It's honestly big shoes to fill. Terry was one of the first ventriloquists I ever saw. And when I saw him on the stage, I just thought, like, I just want to do that. That's amazing. That's why I wanted to come here today. I want to do this live, like, on the Vegas Strip.
Well, good luck to you. And
thank
we
you.
Can't wait to meet thank your friend.
Guys, give it up for my good buddy, Foster. Ready, buddy? Yeah, here we go. Hello. Here we are, buddy, AGT. My cloud is working. What's your plan?
Well, basically, I used you to smuggle me out here, and now I'm gonna show my talent.
He's funny.
So cute.
What's your talent?
Ventriloquism.
That's what I'm doing right now.
Really?
Yes. You think you're a better ventriloquist than me? You think you could talk without moving your lips?
Well, I don't have any, so yeah.
Okay. Well, let's see who's the better ventriloquist by doing some tongue twisters. I'll start by saying Sally sells seashells by the seashore, and then you go after. Okay, okay. Sally sells Sally, come on, okay. Sally,
it's like this. Sally sells seashells by the seashore. Sally sells seashells by the seashore. Sally sells seashells by the seashore. Can you do that without moving your nose?
No, no, I can't.
I love him.
I'm gonna do something I said I would never do.
He wouldn't.
I would.
Please. No.
I'm gonna throw your voice.
What?
Wow.
I threw your voice, it's gone. It's gone, it's over there. Wait, 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 listen, listen, I think I hear it coming back.
What? I have your voice. And that means
I have your voice.
Wow!
Simon.
Yes.
Help me.
Here, here, come here, come here. Oh, that's better. Here, give it up for Foster, everybody. Yeah!
You want to impress the most?
Honestly, I'm really hoping that Heidi likes my dress.
Oh, that's it, that's
it. I picked it specifically, so we'll see.
All right, go on out and make your dream come true right now.
Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you, go right on up.
Hi! Good evening, how are you?
I'm totally kidding. Not about the sign language, that part is real. I'm working with an interpreter tonight. I am really hard of hearing. I perform my steps in English, but I do like to start that way because it does make heckling me an ADA violation.
Hello. What's your name?
How Hello, are Jim. You tonight?
Oh, I'm good. My name is Hayden Crystal. I'm a comedian. I'm actually a touring comic right now. But part of why I wanted to come to America's Got Talent is watching so many other comics with disabilities come here and succeed before I did, like Drew Lynch, DJ Demers years ago. Yeah. When I see other people with disability on this stage and thriving, I know that they were given the tools to be able to succeed here, which is not, yeah.
Thank you so much then for being here tonight. We're ready for you.
Thank you, okay, I'm gonna start. So I dual majored in college. I studied sign language, which that felt like a freebie, right? But I also majored in zookeeping. Which seemed like a really fun thing at the time, but now I have a degree in American Sign Language and zookeeping. And Coco the sign language gorilla died like 4 years ago. So what I'm saying is that comedy has to work out for me. Yeah, this has to go, guys, this has to go good. My safety net is dead, she's gone, so. I know, it's very sad. So I actually, I applied to work at the Coco Foundation when I was in college, and they rejected me because I have hearing loss. But they, yes, boo, the Coco Foundation. They told me I was a liability issue because if the gorilla were to sneak up on me, I would not be able to hear it, which I can't say with any degree of certainty, but probably that seems true. So you guys seem like a nice crowd full of hearing people, so I'm just gonna toss this question out to the room. What are y'all gonna do different if a gorilla sneaks up on you?
It's true.
Yeah, thank you. I would love to know.
That makes a lot of sense.
DM me after the show. I'm just desperate to know what home field advantage y'all have with your 2 second head start. Ridiculous. Nothing. Nothing. The only thing you're going to do different than me is die scared. That's it. That's the only thing. Yeah. Thank you.
Hayden, thank you so much for being here tonight. I had a great time listening to you. I love that you make fun of yourself. I was laughing the whole time. Heidi, what do you think?
We have amazing comedians on the show, and I think that you would be a great addition to what we already have, so you can really battle it out with them.
Simon!
Was that a true story?
Yes.
I mean, it's brilliantly funny. So seriously, and the fact you could turn that into a funny story, which is so crazy that they would do that, to your point, what difference does it make?
I'm
with you.
I've been trying to start Twitter beef with them for like 10 years. So if you guys want
to I'll join you.
That.
I can also see this means an awful lot to you.
Yeah, it's truly a privilege and an honor to just be here. Ah. So thank you.
I'm really happy that we met.
Thank you so much.
I think we're going to vote now for you. Heidi, what is your vote?
I want to see you more, so I'm going to give you a first yes.
I'm going to give you your second yes. Simon?
Hayden, I'm saying yes to you. And Julie, I'm also saying yes to you. She was sweet.
Hayden, talk to me. You seem very emotional. Talk to me right now. What are you feeling?
Just validation from someplace that really meant a lot to me in starting this. And to be here, it's unbelievable. And then I felt like I already won just making it to tonight. And that was, it couldn't have been.
It was a fairy tale of love. Thank you.
This is the story about love. When a guy meets a girl in a bar, he sees the girl, he looks at her, and all he wants to say is a great big
hello. Is it me you're looking for?
She looked lovely. The dress that night she was wearing was
gold.
She wasn't looking at it. So he showed her his best dance moves.
What does the fox say? What the fox say?
Everybody I'm shuffling.
She comes over, she says to go, hey. Thirsty. You want a drink? What you want?
Tequila.
What?
Tequila.
Why?
It makes me happy.
Fair enough. The girl looks at the guy and says, I'm sorry, I've got to go to the toilet. Don't go, he says. Please don't go.
Please don't go.
I love this act.
The girl comes back.
I'm so excited. I just can't hide it. I think I like it.
The girl laughs at the guy and says, hey, wanna come back to my place for a coffee?
The guy says, hey,
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night.
So the guy got with the girl, and now they've been together for 45 years.
If I could turn back time.
And that is the fairy tale of love.
Thank you for watching.
It is good to see you guys out, man. I was talking to the producers. They're like, hey, Emo, we're very excited to have you on the show. We just have a question. Have you booked your accommodation yet? I said, no, I haven't. I'm just looking for somewhere close by, cultured. As soon as I said cultured, they said, we got the perfect place. We said Blacktown.
Is that actually a town here?
It is a town.
I was like, ooh, that sounds nice. As soon as I got there, I was like, ooh, this ain't nice. So I moved areas. I thought this area was nice. It was called Penrith. Have you heard of this? Yeah, it's rough. But it is a massive upgrade from Blacktown, though, because I went from living around poor black people to now living around poor white people. And I love it. Every now and then, I've been getting like a random white guy come up and ask me for like loose change. And I give it to them. But I do it for the wrong reasons, though, ladies and gentlemen. I do it because I kind of feel like I'm rewriting history. Every time I give him change, I'm like, here you go, my man. Just don't spend it all on drugs. If only my mom could see me now. Oh, she's not dead. She's just not here. I was speaking to her on FaceTime this morning. She's like, hey, how's Penrith gone? I'm like, ma, it's so beautiful, very multicultural. You should see it. The white people ask me for money. And she was so proud. She's like, oh my God, you're doing very well, my son. And then she calls my father into the FaceTime. She's like, Michael, come have a look at your son. He has become the king of the whites. I'm going to get buzzed off soon. can I get some water? Sorry, just one moment. Oh, my mouth is so dry.
Here we go.
Ooh. Oh, how unprofessional, I'm so sorry. Water is very hard for black people to find. There's been a lot of tension between white and black people over the last couple of years. But I think it's because we don't understand each other because of our differences in culture. And for us to ever move forward, I feel like we all have to do our part. Would you agree?
Yes.
Yes, I think white people, you need to stop assuming that all black people are out to steal things that are not theirs. And black people, man, we need to stop trying to steal back our stuff from white people, man. I think it's important if we're ever going to make a change, we have to start educating the younger generation. Like, for example, white people, you need to stop lying to your kids. This is my personal favorite lie. Make sure you finish off all your dinner because somewhere in Africa, there's a child that would love to eat it. Nonsense. What you guys don't realize is African parents tell their kids a similar thing. Like, I remember my mom used to tell me, son, make sure you finish off all your dinner because somewhere in Australia, there's a child eating food without seasoning, son. This is sick. Australia Got Talent. Who would have thought that the kid that survived two refugee camps would be on TV? Ladies and gentlemen, I've been Emo Majuk. Thank you.
Yeah!
Oh, very, very good.
Fantastic. Thank you.
Fantastic. Yeah. This is yours.